I got broads in Atlanta, just the lean in the family, credit cards in the scammers, hitting the licks in the van, legacies, family, waiting to see them like a panda, going out like a... How far can this Los Angeles Lakers team really go? And how great can this big three really be? And yeah, I said big three, but obviously there's a lot of questions surrounding this big three. Is it really a big three? What do you guys think down below? I personally believe that it could be. I do personally believe that DeMarcus Cousins has that chance to return to being a third option. He doesn't have to be the star of the team, not even the second star on this team, just a third option. You gotta think about it, he was a 16-8 guy in a Warriors team with 4 NBA All-Stars as arguably the 5th or 4th option on that team, only playing 25 minutes per game and only playing 30 games and then being re-injured. You don't think he can average 4 more points and average 2 more rebounds and be a 20-10 guy again as the third option? I believe that is very possible. So, how far do I think the Los Angeles Lakers can go? And do I think that they are as good as the Los Angeles Clippers? Which means, could they possibly be the best team in the Western Conference? Well, let's find out. Firstly, before I get started, if you are new around here and you enjoy NBA content, be sure to hit that subscribe button for daily NBA content. And if you enjoy these types of videos, be sure to smash that like button as it supports the channel, and that would be greatly appreciated. It would mean a lot. Anyway, let's get into it. Even if he isn't the DeMarcus Cousins that we once knew and watched as the greatest big man in the game, now, even if he's the third option, that is still classified as a big three. LeBron James is arguably the greatest player even in today's NBA at 35 years old. Anthony Davis, if healthy, is the best big man in the game, especially at the power forward position. And then DeMarcus Cousins as that third option along with Kyle Kuzma, the Lakers are still in a very, very good position, and here's why. Of course they're in the Western Conference, which is the toughest conference and has been for many, many years. And whilst the Western Conference is obviously extremely stacked and has improved with teams like the Denver Nuggets most likely improving with Michael Porter Jr. back, and they're obviously just a young team that will most likely improve even more, the Utah Jazz, they've obviously improved a lot, and to me they could be the sleeper in this year's NBA season, and obviously